Let's move on now to the BVR kit that was criticized in the March 4th polls, and it has emerged that one of the firms that unsuccessfully bided for the tender that was later cancelled curiously ended up supplying the kits in a deal between the Kenya and the Canadian governments.
The director of ICT at the IEBC, Desmas Ongondi, made the revelations to the Public Accounts Committee investigating the procurement process of the BVR kits that were at the center of the disputed March 4th elections. Patrick Amimo has the details.
In the dossier.
Members of the National Assembly's Public Accounts Committee are investigating the whole process of acquiring the biometric voter registration kits that culminated in the government-to-government deal. In July last year, the IEBC boss cancelled a 3.9 billion shillings tender to supply 9,750 BVR kits. IEBC Chairman Isaac Hassan later told a joint parliamentary committee then that the process had become murky and had been infiltrated by extraneous factors. Interestingly, one of the firms that initially bidded for the tender of the BVR kits but was not shortlisted became a beneficiary after the Canadian Commercial Corporation signed an MOU with the government of Kenya that laid the framework of government-to-government cooperation.
MOFO, which is the technology arm of Safran Group in France, did participate in BVR1. However, MOFO Technology Canada, which is a wholly owned subsidiary of Safran MOFO France, did not participate.
Which firm supplied?
Canadian Commercial Corporation. They subcontracted.
So we were satisfied that the process went the way it had been contemplated from the beginning.
It appears as if Canada came with some conditions because they knew Kenya had no otherwise.
Was that headhunting? Was it restricted tendering?
By using donor funds, you actually go according to the dictates of the donor. So they would do their own due diligence to identify a supplier.
He who pays the piper.
Yes.
Depending on where our shilling is, the loan in shilling terms will always either increase or decrease. Contractual agreement is in euro.
So, it will cost the Kenyan taxpayer 10 years to repay for the BVR kits. The actual cost is not known, but it will range somewhere between 7.2 billion shillings or more, depending on the prevailing interest rates. Reporting for KTN from Parliament, I'm Patrick Amimo.